Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. This is Brother Patrick, your brother from another mother, coming to you live and or on demand from the outrageously awesome state of North Carolina. Hope you guys are doing all right tonight. May the living God put his peace upon you and his blessings upon you. Hallelujah. I've just been here worshiping the Lord, praising his holy, beautiful, wonderful name. He is the mighty counselor, the wonderful, fairest of 10,000, the lily of the valley, the bright and morning star, the rose of Sharon. Hallelujah. The balm of Gilead. Hallelujah. He is the Christ, the Mashiach, the Messiah, the Son of the living God, the anointed one, the Holy One, the Rock of Ages, the rock smote by Moses. Hallelujah. As this song I'm playing right now, on Christ the solid rock I stand. All other ground is sinking sand. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. My house has been on the rock, as Jesus said, Matthew chapter 6 and 7, the end of the Sermon on the Mount. Matthew chapter 7, the Lord Jesus Christ, the man who hears my words and keeps them. And keeps them is like the man who built his house on a rock. And when the flood came and the storms came, his house was able to stand. And those who hear my words but do not keep them is like the man who built his house on the sand, the sinking sand. And when the flood came and the storms came and the trouble came, his house was destroyed. And great was the fall and destruction of that house, the Lord Jesus Christ tells us. Just like as I'm just coming to mind now about old Lucifer, who was the cherubim, the anointed cherub that covered the throne of God. Great was his fall. Pride is why he fell. You know, it says, O Lucifer, thou son of the morning, how far you have fallen. Why? Because you said, I will be like the Most High. I will ascend on the mountain of God. I will have everyone worship me. All those things. I will. God said, I am. Jesus said, I am the bread of life. Satan said, I will be like the Most High God. I will ascend to the throne. Brothers and sisters, these things ought not be, because pride goeth before destruction. The Bible says, a haughty spirit before a fall. Lots of times people misquote that and say, pride goeth before a fall. But what I just said to you is the way that it's written in the King James. Pride goeth before destruction, a haughty spirit before a fall. You know, praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Hallelujah. Let's worship Him, brothers and sisters. Let's praise Him. Hallelujah. For the Bible says the Spirit of the Lord inhabits the praises of His people. Hallelujah. Let's worship Him. Hallelujah. Glory to God. Hallelujah. He says in His Word, brothers and sisters, also in the Psalms, I just quoted from a psalm. He says in the Psalms, I will enter, and this is a song, maybe you've heard this Christian song from the Psalms. I will enter His gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter His courts with praise. I will say this is the door that a day that the Lord has made, and He has made me glad. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. He has made me glad. I will rejoice forevermore, for He has made me glad. Hallelujah. Let's worship Him. Let's thank Him. That's why this song is, I've been blessed. I want to thank the Lord. Hallelujah. Let's thank Him. Let's thank Him. Let's enter His gates with thanksgiving in our heart. That outer gate. Enter the courts, on into the courts of God with praise. And then finally, into the holy place with worship. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. We thank Him. Then we praise Him. Then we worship Him, brothers and sisters. You know, that's one thing about those denominational churches. You know, I came from that denominational background. They'll even get to praise a little bit sometimes. Thank Him and praise Him. But, you know, you have to really go to a Spirit-filled church to get into worship. There's not many worship songs that you might hear in an old denominational church. You know, and very few praise. You know, how great they are. Usually it's about when we all get to heaven, when the roll is caught up yonder, I'll be there. About us. And there's nothing wrong with that for teaching, brothers and sisters. But when we come to do praise and worship, brothers and sisters, we come to minister to the Lord. The Lord ministers back to us by His Spirit. When we offer up our praise, as the Bible says, as Paul says, offer up yourself a living sacrifice. You know, offer up the praises of your lips. That's Romans chapter 12. We offer up ourselves as a living sacrifice, acceptable and pleasing unto God. So we worship Him, we praise Him, we honor Him. Hallelujah. But I believe the order of worship is just as from the psalmist King David said, I will enter His gates with thanksgiving in my heart. I will enter His courts with praise. I will say this is a day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice in it and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Praise Him. Hallelujah. He's worthy. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord Jesus. This is a day that the Lord has made. Hallelujah. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Praise be the name of the Lord. And thank you, Lord, for another day. Hallelujah. Another day, Lord, you have given us to bring glory to your name, to be a blessing to you and to your kingdom and to your people, Lord. Hallelujah. Bless you, Lord God. Hallelujah. Bless you. Hallelujah. I just feel the anointing as I'm saying it. That's, you know, lots of times people, you know, they watch these videos, like my videos and others who are anointed. They want to enjoy that anointing. But you know, brothers and sisters, God has an anointing for you. You know, it's not just, of course, He has, you know, different anointings for different people. If you're a preacher, of course, you know, you have a different anointing, as the Lord would anoint you to preach and all these kind of things, and how He would have you do a healing anointing for healing ministry, etc., etc. But we all have an anointing. What does He say? And it says in Isaiah that the yoke is broken off because of the anointing. Hallelujah. Jesus quotes from Isaiah 61, there in Luke chapter 4, verse 18, the Spirit of the Lord is upon me because He has anointed me to preach good news to the poor, to set the captives free, to speak deliverance, you know, to the captive, and open the eyes of those who are blind. Praise God and preach the acceptable year of the Lord. Now, the original back there from the Hebrew, it's the year of Jubilee, the 50th year. The Christianity is the year of Jubilee, the church age for the last 2,000 years. We, the church, have been in a Jubilee where all debt is forgiven. All sin is washed away. Hallelujah. We've got the best deal that's ever been offered to mankind and ever been offered in this world, brothers and sisters. Now, you've heard it's been said, if something's too good to be true, it probably is. It probably is. But there is one exception to if it's too good to be true, and that is the gift of salvation. Hallelujah. For by grace you are saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God. Not by works, lest any man should boast. Ephesians chapter 2, verse 8 and 9. Hallelujah. John chapter 3, verse 16. The most famous verse in the Bible. Our Lord Jesus Christ is speaking. And He says, for God so loved the world that He gave His only begotten Son, that whomsoever shall believeth in Him would not perish, but have everlasting life. There's never, ever has been, or never will be a deal like that, brothers and sisters. And praise God Almighty, you're alive today and you're hearing this message and you are living in the age of grace, as we call it. The Israelites didn't have that, brothers and sisters, and the tribulation saints won't have that. The tribulation saints have to endure until the end to be saved. They have to reject the mark. They have to suffer the consequences, as it says. Let this be the wisdom and patience of the saints. Who will be led into captivity will be led into captivity. He who will die by the sword will die by the sword. This is the wisdom and the patience of the saints, the tribulation saints. They're not in the church age, brothers and sisters. They're not part of the bride of Christ. They're not part of the true church. They're the tribulation saints, a whole other category, just like Israel is, separate from the church, hallelujah, in the kingdom of God, even in the millennial reign, and even for eternity. There's different callings and giftings for those three different groups. Israel, well, you got the, I take that back, there's another group. There's the pre-Israel saints, like Enoch and all those guys, the original patriarchs. Then you've got the nation of Israel. Then you've got the church. Then you've got the tribulation saints. And then another group, the holy angels of God. All have different assignments and different tasks for eternity for God. Our brothers and sisters, praise be to God who has given us the Lord Jesus Christ to be our Redeemer, our kinsman Redeemer. Hallelujah. From the story of Ruth, He is our kinsman Redeemer. You know, Boaz, the great-grandfather of King David, is a type of the Messiah, type of the Christ, is a kinsman Redeemer who redeems the Gentile
woman. Hallelujah, Ruth. Hallelujah, the daughter-in-law of Naomi. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Praise God Almighty, because we have been redeemed. Hallelujah. I've been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Hallelujah. Been redeemed by the blood of the Lamb. Filled with the Holy Ghost I am. Thank you, Lord. I'm under the blood. I've been redeemed. Praise His holy name, brothers and sisters. Exalt the Lord our God. Hallelujah. Bless His holy name. Bless His holy name, brothers and sisters. I want to pray for you that the anointing of the Most High God would overshadow you and overtake you. Hallelujah. You want to be filled with the Holy Spirit? Empty thyself of the world and the cares of this life. Hallelujah. For the things of this world are surely passing away, the Word of God says. Matthew chapter 6, back to the Sermon on the Mount. What did Jesus say? You can't add an inch to your height by worrying. You can't add any hair to your head by worrying. You can't, seeking after the things of this world by clothing and food and all those things. Don't you see the lilies of the valley, Jesus said, how beautiful they are? There, one lily in the valley is more beautiful than King Solomon in all of his fine regalia and arrayed clothing as a king and the richest man that lived in the history of the world. Don't you know that God so clothed the grass of the field? How much more will He clothe you, O ye of little faith? But first, seek ye the kingdom of God. Seek ye first the kingdom of God and His righteousness and all those things you need in the natural. Food, clothing, and shelter, and peace, and all of those fruit of the Spirit. Peace, joy, and all those things are fruit of the root of Christ that be in you. Hallelujah. For the Bible says that in Him we live and breathe and move and have our being. Hallelujah. It's in Christ. Are you a grafted in wild olive branch into the root of Yeshua HaMashiach, into the Messiah? Hallelujah, to the promises of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob. For the Bible says that we are adopted children of Abraham, who was a man of faith. Abraham was justified not by the deeds of the law, for he lived before the law. He was justified by faith. Hallelujah, Romans chapter 4. Praise God Almighty, brothers and sisters. Are you justified? Are you sanctified? Are you ready to be glorified? Hey, that theological word, glorified? God will also glorify those who've been sanctified and justified, or justified and sanctified is the order. To be glorified is talking about the resurrection, brothers and sisters, a.k.a. what we call the doctrine of the rapture, is the resurrection of the church, hallelujah, of the true bride of Christ, hallelujah. Before you can be glorified, you got to be justified. Before you can be just, after you get justified, you got to get sanctified, and then you get glorified. Hallelujah. As the Word of God tells us, the Apostle Paul tells us that too, brothers and sisters. So how do we get justified? We're justified by the blood of Jesus. We're justified by grace through faith. Hallelujah. In the finished work of Christ, Hebrews chapter 3 and chapter 4. Don't try to rest in a day and call that a work. But rest every day in Christ, as the Word of God tells us. Hebrews chapter 3 and chapter 4, there is another rest, a rest that's in Christ Jesus, not on a particular day of the week, but we rest 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, for all eternity in the finished work of Christ. For by His stripes we were healed, hallelujah. Through His blood we have the remission of sins and the forgiveness of sins by His righteousness, hallelujah. Praise God, for the righteousness of Christ has been imputed unto us. It's been given unto us by grace through faith, hallelujah. Jesus took upon Himself my sickness and diseases. Jesus took upon Himself the sin of the world, hallelujah. He became sin for us, the Bible says. Just as Jesus refers back to what old Moses did when they were wandering in the desert, when the people were tempting God, God sent serpents among the people, and it bit them. And what God told Moses to do, take a staff and put a serpent up on that staff and hold it up high. But people are bit by that serpent. They will look unto the serpent, they'll live. If they don't look up to the serpent, they will, the serpent that, the bronze serpent that you put on a pole, if they don't look up to it, they're going to die. And Jesus talking in John chapter 3 to Nicodemus when he said in John 3:3, except a man be born again, he cannot enter the kingdom of heaven. In the same chapter, he said, for God so loved the world that he gave his only begotten son, that whomsoever shall believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. He went on to say in that same chapter, just as Moses lifted up the serpent in the desert, so should the Son of Man be lifted up. And if I be lifted up, I will draw all men unto me. Now, I feel the Holy Ghost on that, brothers and sisters. And what is Jesus saying? He's saying what Paul tells us later on, that Jesus became sin for us. He took upon the sin of the world. That's why when he was in the Garden of Gethsemane, he sweat as if it sweat and labored in prayer as if it were drops of blood coming out of him, because the sin of the world, the darkness was descending on him. That's why he said, it's time for my time to depart out of this world is at hand. Hallelujah. Jesus took upon himself our sicknesses, our diseases, our sins, our infirmities, the chastisement of our peace is what it says back there in the King James chapter 53, the chastisement. You know, chastisement is like punishment. The chastisement for our sin was upon him, and by his stripes we were healed. Isaiah 53, 54, and 55. Hallelujah. Isaiah 53, 4 and 5. Hallelujah. Praise God. And with his stripes we are healed. Hallelujah. Praise God that the chastisement of our peace was upon him. But now our peace has been returned through redemption through the blood of Yeshua. Hallelujah, brothers and sisters. I know maybe this sounds foreign to many of you because you don't hear the gospel. I'm giving you the good news, as it says in Hebrews, a better covenant. A better covenant. Hallelujah. A better of covenant. It says in Hebrews that that which is old is waxing old and passing away. The Old Testament is old and waxing and waxing away. Hebrews tells us, the Word of God tells us, but we have a better covenant made by the blood of Yeshua. Hallelujah. The power is when you begin to speak the gospel. That's when revival power comes. That's when the anointing comes, because the anointing, what did Jesus say? This is what I'm trying to get across to you. Jesus said, a lot of you want to be baptized in the Holy Spirit, haven't received it. What did Jesus say in Acts chapter 1, verse 8? You shall receive power, the anointing, baptism of the Holy Spirit with evidence of speaking in tongues, when the Holy Spirit shall come upon you to be a witness for me. What I'm doing right now, brothers and sisters, is witnessing about Jesus. It's not about the gifts. The gifts are signs and wonders to follow those who believe, to confirm with signs and wonders that the gospel that I'm proclaiming to you is true, followed by signs and wonders, confirming the word with signs and wonders. The Bible tells us what the apostles did in the book of Acts. So what did Jesus say? As I just told you, Luke chapter 4, verse 18, Jesus quoted from Isaiah 61, the Spirit of the Lord upon me is what? What's the Spirit of the Lord upon us for? To set the captives free, to open the eyes of the blind. Yes, Jesus did it in the natural as a sign of what was happening in the spiritual. Just like the man, he put the mud on his eyes and had him wash it off. And after he was healed at the pool of Siloam, he came to Jesus and Jesus told him that he was the Messiah. He began to worship him and Jesus said, you know, you were blind, but now you see. But, you know, too bad for those who say they can see, because they're going to be blinded. See, Jesus is talking spiritual blindness. The Pharisees said, Jesus, are you talking about us? Are you saying that we're blind? Yes, Jesus said, it would be better if you say you're blind, so that you may see, then to say you can see and then become blind, because they had rejected the day of their visitation. Israel has rejected the day of their visitation, brothers and sisters, and they've been suffering for that for 2,000 years, brothers and sisters. But that day is coming to an end, because the Lord will begin to deal with them. As the Bible calls it, the time of Jacob trouble, the strange work of Yahweh, the 70th week of Daniel, we call it the tribulation period. God's time to deal with Israel, brothers and sisters. The time for God to deal with Israel. Hallelujah. We've been set free from the curse of the law, brothers and sisters. Praise God. Praise God Almighty, through whom all blessings flow. Praise God, all ye creatures here below. Praise God, Father, Son, and Holy Ghost. Let's bless his holy name, brothers and sisters. Let's honor him and let's exalt him, that he may use us as a witness. Now, what I've been doing to you is, it's the straight up most exact thing that God wants us to do, to proclaim that by grace you are saved through faith, not of your own, but a gift of God. The Bible says the wages of sin is death, like Adam and Eve. God told them, when you eat the fruit, you're going to die. The wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ. Eternal life through Jesus Christ. There's no other name under heaven where we might be saved, Peter told us in the book of Acts. Jesus said, John chapter 14, verse 6, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man comes to the Father except by me, the Lord Jesus Christ said. So why are these people on there talking about the Torah, talking about the law, aka the old covenant that God made with the nation of Israel? One group of people, the natural seed descendants of Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, the 12 sons of Jacob and their children. God made a covenant with that natural seed. What does it tell us in Galatians? That the law, or the Torah, as people want to quote Hebrew words, the Torah is a schoolmaster. It is a nanny, is a more correct word, they say. It is a schoolmaster or a nanny to bring us to what? To the knowledge of sin and death. God did not say in his word by the unction of his Holy Spirit, the word of God is written by holy men of old as they were carried along by the Holy Spirit, the Bible tells us. All scripture is for inspiration of God and for proof of God. What does he say in there? He says that the law was a schoolmaster to bring us to the knowledge of sin and death. It doesn't say the law was a schoolmaster that brought us to salvation or to eternal life, or that if we obey it, we'll have eternal life. No, it's a schoolmaster that brings us to the knowledge of sin and death. It is the death knell in the coffin. The law is the death nails in our coffins. It tells us there is none righteous, no, not one. All have sinned and fallen short of the glory of God. If you've disobeyed the law at one point, you've disobeyed the whole thing. You're a lawbreaker. You're an alien and an enemy of God. Hallelujah. Because you have transgressed the law of God. Hallelujah. None are righteous, no, not one. Hallelujah. But thanks be to God. Hallelujah. That has caused us to triumph through the blood of Yeshua HaMashiach. Hallelujah. That's the good news. Hallelujah. That we're able to triumph over the requirements of the law by grace through faith by the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. We've got the victory, not by what we can do, not by the deeds of the law, but as the Bible says, by the deeds of the law shall no flesh be justified. Hallelujah. But I've been justified. I've been sanctified, and I'll be glorified. Hallelujah. The rapture by the blood of Yeshua, by grace through faith in the blood, the cleansing power of the blood of Jesus. Hallelujah. That's why I can boldly say, come before the throne, as Paul said, and boldly say, God is my helper. Hallelujah. I can boldly say, hallelujah, come boldly before the throne of grace to obtain mercy, as Paul tells us in Hebrews. Hallelujah. I've got the victory, victory, victory in Jesus. Hallelujah. And you do too, brothers and sisters. You can do all things through Christ who strengthens you. Hallelujah. Philippians 4:19. Hallelujah. My God shall supply all of your needs according to his riches in Christ Jesus. That's Philippians 4:19. Praise the living God, brothers and sisters. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy, righteous, wondrous, awesome name. Hallelujah. For he is our salvation. He is our peace, who became peace for us. Hallelujah. Our deliverer, our maker, our redeemer, our creator, our judge, our righteousness, our salvation. Hallelujah. Is all in one person. The Son of Man, the Son of God, Yeshua HaMashiach, Jesus the Messiah. Hallelujah. Blessed be his holy, righteous name. Hallelujah. For he is wonderful, counselor, mighty God. Hallelujah. The everlasting King of Kings, the deliverer. Hallelujah. Blessed be his name. Glory to his name. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Honor and glory, all honor and glory to our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. Bless his name, brothers and sisters. Let's pray. Father, in the name of the living God. Hallelujah. Yeshua HaMashiach, Father, we come before you right now. Lord, we declare and decree right now that your blood is more than enough for us. Your name is more than enough for us. The work you did at the cross was more than enough for us. Hallelujah. Thy grace is sufficient for us, Lord God. For you have chosen us, Lord, from the foundation of the world to deliver us. Hallelujah. From deception, from destruction, from judgment, from death, hell, and the grave. Hallelujah, Lord. You have chosen us, Lord, to be your children, to be your bride, to be your sanctified remnant from this hell, destruction coming upon this earth, Lord God, that we know as the tribulation period, Lord God. For you have set us free from the curse of the law. Hallelujah, Lord. And your word says that the redeemed of the Lord say so. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord Jesus Christ on high. Hallelujah. And blessed be the Most High God, El Elyon, King of all kings. Hallelujah. The creator, the redeemer of mankind. Hallelujah. For God, you are our salvation. Hallelujah. El Yeshua, God is my salvation. Hallelujah. Blessed be the name of the Lord God Most High, Creator of heaven and earth. Hallelujah. And blessed be the adopted sons of Abraham. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Blessed be your name. Father, I ask you to release your peace. And I speak it right now. Release the peace. The spirit of peace be upon all who watch this video and hear these words. Hallelujah. That you may be a doer of the word that you heard today. Not a hearer only. Hallelujah. As James tells us, the half-brother of Jesus. Be a doer of the word and not a hearer only. Hallelujah, Father, we praise you right now. We exalt your name. Hallelujah. Bless you, Father, in the name of Jesus. God bless you, brothers and sisters. I'm getting ready to head out to Nashville. Praise God to all the brothers and sisters I'll be meeting there. I decided to fly instead of drive, so I was able to wait another day or two before I went. Praise God. I'll be flying out to Nashville. I still have some time to see people on Friday afternoon. If you contact me, if you're in the Nashville area, can be there in the afternoon. I'll be there. I have available time to see people till about 5 o'clock on this coming Friday, June the 12th. Open time slots. God bless you guys. May the peace of God be upon you. I just want to say to all the people that I sent books out to, you should have already gotten them books in prayer oil. They're already gone out. And I got a whole new batch of about 10 books or 12 books in anointing oil to go out. And I'll be mailing that right before I fly in the morning. So God bless you guys. Bless your lives. Be filled with the presence of God. And may God go with you. May he be your rear guard. And may he go before you with his grace and favor of the living God. I speak that the favor of God be upon you in the name of Jesus. God bless you all.